season, paying the penalty for last season and indiscipline at the end of the Hampden match has cost them four top players. Eight, in fact, are missing for a variety of reasons. So a bigger burden than ever falls on skipper Maurice Malpass this afternoon. With 42 Scotland caps to his credit, he has the experience to guide this recast side. He celebrated his 29th birthday a week ago today. Another important player is Billy McKinley at the age of just 22. He made more than 40 first-team appearances last season and is surely a player destined for the very top. Celtic go into a crucial season without the talents of injured skipper Paul McStay, but Charlie Nicholas is fit and leads Liam Brady's first competitive selection. And there's Brady's first big signing, who makes his competitive debut. Tony Cascarino was signed last month for a club record of £1.1 million. He'll be hoping to improve on a disappointing goal-scoring record at Aston Villa, where he hit just 12 in 50 games. Another Republic of Ireland internationalist is Chris Morris, who also looks forward to an important season in his career. He lost the fullback position to Mark McNally last season, but now has been given the chance to make it his own again. The referee is Mr. Brian McGinley from Balfron. Well, Liam Brady, a big day for him, his first competitive match as the Celtic manager. And of course, facing Jim McLean, who's the longest serving manager in Scottish football. Day number one for Brady, year number 20 for Jim McLean. So Dundee United get this first Premier League match of the season underway. The 65th, in fact, between the clubs in the Premier Division. Celtic have won 27, United 21, and 16 of the games have been drawn. It always tends to be an attractive fixture with a few goals, with Boris Malpass getting an early touch. But now by Alan Preston, long one forward for French to chase. And the corner kick conceded by Derek White. So some early pressure for the Celtic defence to face. Dundee United with Jochen Müller in their lineup, signed last night from Mannheim FC in Germany, wearing the number 5 shirt. Then it gets in the header, and Pat Bonner to Celtic's rescue. Well, Jochen Müller already showing what a danger he can be. Lovely little turn there by John O'Neill, and Müller getting above the Celtic defence. Pat Bonner gathering the ball at the second attempt. Fulton challenged by John O'Neill. Celtic have the throw-in. You can see the German player looking rather rueful there. The referee missed the incident, a little clash off the ball. There's Müller involved again, Cascarino's in there. Good save by Alan Mann. Alan Mann having to show his reflexes to prevent Cascarino opening the score for Celtic. Wogan with the throw. Cleared by Cleland. Wogan firing in the high one. Trouble here for United. It's a goal for Celtic. Charlie Nicholas scores Celtic's first goal of the season. Well, it seems to have taken a bit of a knock, but the throw coming in from Rogan caught the United defence, and there's Nicholas with the header into the back of the net. Rogan for Celtic. Nice little switch of play, putting Malpass under pressure as Morris came forward. Celtic have the throw. And Brady and McMartin giving instructions to their players. By Cleland. Mascarina for Celtic. Nice little touch from Coyne. And he scores number 2. That was magnificent play between Tommy Coyne and Charlie Nicholas. Great play by Tommy Coyne. A lovely little flick through to Nicholas. Great awareness from Nicholas. And Tommy Coyne, who was the only Celtic player to score against United last season in the four league matches, well, he strikes again to make it 2-0 to Celtic. Not quite for Celtic. Ball forward for Cascarino to chase. Miller's in there with him. And Celtic have the corner kick. Main organising his defence. It's Steve Fulton to take the corner. Driving a low one into the path of John Collins. Well, Charlie Nicholas almost making contact. And Alan Main had to be alert. But it was certainly a difficult moment for the Dundee United defence. The low ball played to Collins by Fulton. And Charlie Nicholas challenged there by Alan Preston. Not put out by Nicholas, but he gives it away. Michael O'Neill to John O'Neill. Malpass going on the outside, trying to drive his team forward. Bowman. Good play by Bowman, right across the face of goal and pushed behind by Chris Morris. Well, great pace from Bowman as he took on Peter Grant. Great cross and Morris to Celtic's rescue. So in comes the corner kick. And the referee pointing to the spot, indicating that the player's jersey was pulled, that Ferguson's jersey was pulled. He's awarded a penalty kick to Dundee United. So the yellow card shown to Pat Bonner. There was a tug on the jersey of Duncan Ferguson as he challenged for the ball. So a chance for United to get themselves back in the game. Tremendous penalty kick by Michael O'Neill. So United themselves back into this match, and the United 1, Celtic 2. Beautifully struck by Michael O'Neill, high into the net, giving Bonner no chance. Again, Liam Brady on the track side, giving instructions. Charlie Nicholas. Out of play. It's a throw-in to Celtic. Again, Rogan with the long throw. That's how the first goal came along. Here's Rogan again. Nicholas, chance on for Chris Morris. Well blocked by Alan Main. Well, I remember Chris Morris scoring a fabulous goal here a few seasons back. There was a real chance for him. He struck it well, and that was good goalkeeping again by Alan Main. Jim McLean now shouting instructions with 35 minutes gone. Unhappy there with his defence. Allen flipping it forward away by Grant. Now it's Preston for United. Challenged by Morris. Cleared by Peter Grant. Bowman, O'Neill. Celtic not managing to get the ball out of the danger area. Here's John O'Neill. Ferguson coming in. Well, again, the height of Duncan Ferguson causing problems for the Celtic defence. But really, there was a lot of dithering before Ferguson got in the header. Well taken by Bonner. Free kick to United, the challenge by Morris on French. Well, Billy mistakenly getting needlessly involved with Jerry Craney. The SFA have just recently sent out a letter to clubs warning them about players indulging in actions like this. And it really is so unnecessary. The hand raised there by the player. There's Dan Budge from Brian McGinley. And Billy McGinley goes into the book. Four bookings in this first half. And now Jerry Craney has been called over. And he also is being booked. So Bowman and McKinley for United. Bonner, White, and now Craney of Celtic also on the yellow card. And referee moving over now to the word into one of the benches. Switch to the left. They're all going behind for the goal kick. And the referee is coming over at one or two players, and hopefully during the half-time interval the manager will be able to calm them down. So we're now into injury time. And getting the touch, Craney, Collins, oh, marvellous goal! A wonderful goal from John Collins. Jubilation among the Celtic fans. Just look at the smile there on the player's face. But it was excellent play by Celtic. Collins, from well outside the area, catching men off his line, and it's 3-1 to Celtic. What a time to score. So referee Brian McGinley brings the first half to a close. We've seen some excellent football. Celtic starting so well, they wobbled a bit, but great play there, giving them the third goal. And the half-time score here at Tannadice, Dundee United 1, Celtic 3. Substitute Jerry Craney and Charlie Nicholas get the second half underway. And United have made a half-time substitution. Miksu Patalainen coming on for Hamish French. So Jim McLean will be hoping that the big Finnish strikers, height and weight, can cause some problems for the Celtic defence. Patalainen winning his first challenge. Duncan Ferguson, he didn't seem to know where the ball was, but he recovers well. Still Ferguson. The referee awarding a free kick. Ferguson taking on several Celtic defenders, but eventually it all came to nothing. Matalainen, and watched by Morris. United have the throw. Ferguson, it breaks out to Neil. And United pull another one back. Michael O'Neill driving the ball into the back of the net for his own second goal of the match. It's now Dundee United 2, Celtic 3. So 49 minutes gone. It was a high throw from Miksu Patalainen. It broke to John O'Neill. And then Michael O'Neill stabbing the ball past Pat Bonner. Out by Cleland, but the foul by John O'Neill on Anton Rogan. So they have the free kick. Rogan. Oh, the defence all over the place. John Collins. Well, the United defence not looking at all clever as the cross was delivered by Rogan. The goalkeeper and Alec Clelland in a mix-up, and John Collins sending the ball behind. The ball cut out by Derek Point. Play by McKinley. Bowman, chances on here! Oh, a marvellous goal by Duncan Ferguson! He's been threatening to do that the whole of the game. 68 minutes gone. It's Dundee United 3, Celtic 3. Well, Billy McKinley started all with that lovely pass to Bowman, and he hit the early cross right onto the head of Ferguson, right into the corner of the net. Superb goal. For Celtic, he's got Nicholas to his left, he goes it alone. Oh, Malpass and Main between them, managed to bump up the danger, but that was excellent play by Steve Fulton.
Paul Sturrock trying to get his men going.
And Ferguson getting the touch.
And ball by Rogan.
Collins. Goal by John Collins. An amazing goal by John Collins. Well, he struck in the last minute of the first half. He scored again now with just 3.5 minutes to go. It was Craney who got the vital touch there, and Collins with his left foot right into the corner of the net. Well, his first goal was brilliant. That one really was out of this world. This is a match you'll remember. He was certainly a bit shy in the scoring sticks last season as he settled into the club, but he's now put Celtic 4-3 ahead.
Coyne. Galloway.
So we're now moved into injury time. The ball cannons off the head of Morris. The chance is on! Oh, marvellous save from Pat Bonner. John O'Neill getting in the shot. Well, a remarkable save by Bonner. John O'Neill can't quite believe it, but full stretch and tipping the ball just over the crossbar. Well, a remarkable finish to this match. In comes Patalina, it's headed away by Galloway. United committing everyone forward. In fact, Jerry Craney on his own, just inside his own half. Celtic fans want the whistle to sound. Injury time played, it's Craney for Celtic. Charlie Nicholas, Craney, but the offside flag has gone up. There goes the final whistle. Well, a winning start for Liam Brady in a quite remarkable match. The final score here at Tannadice, Dundee United 3, Celtic 4.